Greetings, Agents. My name is Agent Leo. Welcome to Batman Arkham Knight. And, yeah, there should be, yeah, there's a lot of extra content available. Sorry about that. I'm not gonna show them off. You know, it's gonna be a surprise. You know, yeah. I don't care about leaderboards or anything. This is gonna be a long one, guys. So, hang tight. I've got you under my skin. I've got you deep in the heart of me. So deep in my heart that you're really a part of me. And look who that is. Anything come what might for the sake of having you near, in spite of a warning voice comes in the night and repeats in my ear. Don't you know, little fool, you never can win. Let's burn, Joker. I'm button mashing. I know you should probably never do a video game, but... Oh, I'm getting goosebumps.
This is how it happened. This is how the Batman died.
Wait, what? I didn't agree to this. I didn't agree for the Dark Knight to be dying on me. Vicki Vale show?
The Joker was cremated. I pressed the button and burnt the evil bastard myself.
Looking for Easter eggs, guys. That's all I'm doing.
And then,
this game's packed full of them.
Gotham braced itself for the inevitable power.
All these diner pile.
But it didn't come. Crime actually fell. Deep down, I knew war was coming.
Of course.
I was just waiting for someone to pull the trigger.
Halloween pate. So this is taking on Halloween night. Nice zoom in perspective. Like it. Henry Adams is missing. Soda, cola.
Thanks.
Ooh, no Metropolis. There's another Easter egg.
Oh, thanks, honey. So, what'll it be? The usual?
Sure.
Chicken salad with no dressing.
No, you know what? Make it waffles. With a side of bacon. Don't tell my wife.
Whatever you say, officer. Oh, and if you want some more coffee, just shout.
Hey, I'm sorry to interrupt your dinner, officer, Owens. There's a guy smoking over there in the corner booth.
Wait here. I'll have a word.
I believe that's supposed to be one of the game developers. Any more Easter eggs? How about here? Lady Gotham? Oh, Johnny Charisma? Okay, what about...
He's just been sitting there, staring out the window.
Okay, let's go over here. When Enterprises pledges $300 million Arkham City redevelopment, Crimes
figure, crime figures at an all-time low. So we saw the Metropolis Easter egg. Oh, there's an A. I don't know what the A stands for. Oh, Jesus Christ! Oh, what's... Yo, this is trippy, man. You gay Officer Owens. What is this? I'm not going to tell you what it is. Don't look at me with that ugly face! I'll make me shoot you. Black Canary Club.
Not so many.
Oh.
The only people left on the streets are the sort that enjoy the chaos.
Gotham's finest.
Scum. Criminals. And worse. Not enough good people left to stop.
Batman, you've forgotten. Yes, he is.
It took just 24 hours for us to lose control of the city.
Damn, 24 hours, really?
Tonight, Gotham's relying on one man to save us all.
There it is. There he is, the one man to save Gotham.
Scarecrow? We were tracking an unknown military vehicle speeding through Chinatown. It's the only lead we've had all night, but they gave us the slip. With the evacuation, I just don't have the manpower left in the city. If you find it,
Tell your men not to engage. I'll deal with it.
Do you really think Scarecrow's crazy enough to detonate a chemical weapon in Gotham?
I won't let that happen, Jim. In case you need to reach me, it's going to be a long night.
Because, you know, Batman's got to take care of it.
Oracle, I need the location of Unit 247.
Already working on it. How's my dad doing?
He's holding up.
Somehow, he always does. Okay, I'm sending through this worker's location. Be careful. It's not looking good out there.
No, because... got some character bios here. Real name, Barbara Gordon, occupation, information broker, based in Gotham City, eye color blue, hair color red, height 5 feet 11 inches, weight 126 pounds, first appearance, Suicide Squad number 23, 1989, wow, my bad, oops. Okay. The daughter of Gotham City's Police Commissioner, James W. Gordon, Barbara Gordon, fought crime alongside Batman as Batgirl until she was paralyzed from the waist down and confined to a wheelchair because of Joker. Barbara has since adopted the new identity of Oracle and now supports Batman with her computer expertise, providing him with a constant stream of information in the field to aid his battle against crime. Memory recall of everything she sees and reads. Extensive headquarters in Gotham City's clock tower. High level hacking computer skills. Remains skilled with its Christmas sticks and batarangs. Oh. Alfred Pennyworth. Real name Alfred Pennyworth. Occupation butler based in Gotham City. Eye color blue. Hair color gray. Formerly black. Alright. Height 6 feet. Weight 160 pounds. First appearance, Batman number 16, April through May 1943. After a varied career, Alfred Pennyworth was employed as the Wayne family's butler. When Bruce Wayne's parents were killed, Alfred raised the young orphan and reluctantly aided him in his quest to become the Batman. Alfred's main skills, ranging from cooking to combat medicine, making him Batman's staunchest ally, and his formal demeanor helps ground the Dark Knight and deflect those who might otherwise suspect Bruce Wayne's true identity. Skilled actor, trained in emergency medical techniques, proficiency with mechanical and computer systems, excellent domestic scientist, unflappable manner. Okay. Real name, Bruce Wayne. Occupation, world's greatest detective, based in Gotham City. Eye color blue, hair color black, height 6'2", weight 210 pounds. First appearance, Detective Comics number 27, May 1939. So that's what the DC, and DC stands for, guys, Detective Comics. When his parents were gunned down in front of him, young Bruce Wayne resolved to rid Gotham of the criminal element that took their lives. He trained extensively to achieve mental and physical perfection. In addition to mastering martial arts, detective techniques, and criminal psychology. Dressing as about to prey on criminals' fears, Batman fights crimes with the aid of specialized gadgets and vehicles, operating out of a secret Batcave below Wayne Manor. Following the events of Arkham City, many of Gotham's citizens are convinced that Batman focused a founding rule by killing his arch-nemesis, the Joker. Training to physical and mental peak, arsenal of gadgets, vehicles, and advanced technology, inventor, detective, genius level intellect, expert in most known forms of martial arts, trained in all aspects of criminology. So that's how Batman is so good, guys. He's well named Bruce Wayne, occupation CEO/philanthropist, based in Gotham City, eye color blue, hair color black, height 6 foot 2, weight 210 pounds, first appearance, Detective Comics number 227, May 1939. Okay, so it's different for Bruce Wayne. Okay, born into the wealthy Wayne family, Bruce Wayne had an idyllic childhood, but after witnessing his parents' violent murder in Crime Alley, Bruce dedicated his life to battling criminals. He struggled a little for years, training his mental and physical abilities to their peak. Gotham City welcomed him home, not knowing that society's favorite billionaire playboy is also the Batman. Following Arkham City debacle and prison's subsequent closure, Bruce Wayne once again came to Gotham's rescue, footing the bill for its extensive redevelopment. Billionaire playboy by day, Batman by night, Gotham's most eligible battler. Real name, James W. Gordon, Occupation Police Commissioner. Based in Gotham City, eye color blue, hair color white, formerly brown. Okay, cool. Height 6 feet, weight 180 pounds. First appearance, Detective Comics number 27, May 1939. Police Commissioner James W. Gordon dedicated his career to cleaning up the corruption in the Gotham City Police Department, a goal he has come a long way towards accomplishing. He has been equally tough on crime, and in the pursuit of making Gotham City safe for all citizens, Gordon has forged an uneasy alliance with Gotham's other top crime fighter, mysterious vigilant known as Batman. Oh, you dare, little man. Since the closure of Arkham City and the death of Joker, Gordon has overseen a period of relative calm in Batman and Gotham, with crime steadily declining. On the back of these successes, many see Gordon as a prime candidate to become the city's next mayor. Experienced police officer, trained criminologist, proficient in hand-to-hand fighting, expert marksman. Okay, good to know, guys. We are learning about the citizens of Gotham. Real name, Jonathan Crane, occupation, criminal mastermind, psychiatrist. Ace in Gotham City, eye color blue, hair color brown, even though it's hard to tell. With the mask, it's like stitched onto his face. Height, 6 foot, weight 140 pounds. First appearance, got world's finest, number 3, September 1941. So he's one of Batman's oldest villains. Self-proclaimed master of fear, Dr. Jonathan Crane is an obsessive and deranged former psychiatrist who uses a combination of experimental drugs and psychological tactics to exploit his victims' fears and phobias. Prolonged exposure to his own toxin has rendered Scarecrow unable to experience the fear he so desperately craves. The only person who can still elect terror from Scarecrow is Batman. Following his attacks on the Dark Knight Arkham Asylum, Scarecrow was mauled by Killer Croc. Rumor has it, since he has restructured his face to resemble his iconic mask, while plotting his revenge against Batman and Gotham. So, his whole face has been reconstructed to look like his mask, which is pretty cool. Master of Fear, Professor of Psychology, Expert Chemist. So, after being mauled by Killer Croc, you think so, huh? So, apparently after Gotham Asylum, he was too busy reconstructing his face, hence why he didn't appear in Arkham. Hence why he didn't appear in Gotham City. And guys, I have this on a harder difficulty, so these criminals are going to be a little bit tougher. Okay, never. What difficulty is this on? I must know. Because that seemed too easy. We're not.
Thanks, Batman. I thought they were gonna kill
me. Oh, they are, actually. They're still going to trust me. Ooh, how are we going to even the odds? No, don't tell me. Don't tell me we're going to use what I think we're going to use. Don't tell me. Yes! That is sick looking. Journey into night. Do it! Okay, well now the Batmobile is like too close. Let's bring it over here. Alright. Get over here, buddy. Get over here. I know our tire is just on your face and all, but get over here. Oh!
Where's Scarecrow? Go to hell.
Wrong answer. Oh, don't worry. It will be. No! Alrighty, guys. I'm back. Let's go.